Praise the Lord, saints of God. Glory be to God. Blessed be the God and Father of our precious Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ the righteous. Glory be to God. Amen, amen, amen. Well, I want to appreciate everyone for tuning in on our Word Encounter service tonight. Amen. The Lord had us to arrange this setting. Amen. Every Tuesday, 6:30 p.m. Amen. The Word Encounter Hour. This is the setting, the time that God has prepared for us to have an encounter with Him through His Word. Amen. Word Encounter. The Bible says in Psalms 107, verse 20, that He sent His Word and healed and delivered us from all our destruction. Glory be to God. So God has subjected every sickness, every disease, every destructive force of the enemy, He has subjected it to His Word. Amen. Glory be to God. And so the Word of God, amen, is the final say. Amen. And all you need is a word. The Bible says, amen, that heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will remain forever. And Jesus said in Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Amen. And then the Bible goes on to tell us, amen, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And then in Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3, the Bible tells us He upholds all things by the Word and by the Word of His power. Glory to God. So all you need is a word, because there's one thing that answers everything, and that's the Word of God. Amen. Praise God. So I want to encourage you tonight, amen, to go get your Bibles, get you a pen, get you a notepad. So as we refer to Scripture, you can write these Scripture references down. In days to come, you can go back over them and strengthen your faith, feed your faith, develop your faith on the Word. Amen. Glory to God. And also, while you're getting your Bibles, why don't you reach out to a coworker, a neighbor, a loved one, a relative and friend. Get them hooked on to this word supply tonight. Amen. Because whatever you help others receive, that's what the Lord is committing to help you receive. Amen. The Bible tells us in Ephesians 6, verse 8, whatsoever good thing any man doeth, the same shall he receive from the Lord. So whatever you help others receive, that's what the Lord commits Himself to help you receive. Amen. Glory be to God. Well, we want to appreciate you again for hooking on tonight. You're in the right place at the right time to receive the right thing from your Heavenly Father. Amen. Glory to God. Many people, they're interested in natural, temporal things. Amen. And so they give their life, their resources, and all of their energies and times to secure these things. Amen. But the main interest and concern that a person should have is for the state and condition of their soul. Because your soul is the part of you. It's the real you. It's the part of you that determines, amen, your existence. It's the part of you that determines what comes into your life. It's the part of you that determines the quality of life you live. Amen. Or the status of life. Amen. And see, many people, they're interested in natural human life or the behavior and manner of life, but they have no interest at all in eternal life. Amen. And that's the life that Jesus came to give. Now, eternal life doesn't simply mean that we're going to just live forever. All of us are going to exist from forever somewhere. Amen. Whether heaven or hell. Amen. You're never going to stop existing. Amen. Just like you take matter itself. Just take the product or the material that this bottle of water was made of. Amen. Well, we can tear it up when we get through with it, throw it in the trash. Amen. We could even burn it. Amen. But it's matter. It never stops existing. It just goes into another form. Amen. And that's the same way your soul does. It never stops existing. Amen. This is this temporal house, this flesh and bone. This is just the body our soul is temporarily living in. Amen. It's just like the house you moved out of before you moved in the house you're in now. Amen. That house may still be existing, but you're not there anymore. You just moved on. It's the same way with your soul. Amen. It'll never stop existing. So the concern, the value, the importance should be based upon or put upon the state and the degree of the soul. Amen. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. And what determines the degree of your life or the degree of life that is in your soul is the degree of word that you are feeding it. Amen. Just as your natural man has an appetite, so does your soulless man have an appetite. And just as your natural man eats food, amen, natural food, your soulless man has something that it eats, and it's the word of God. Glory to God. Amen. And what degree of life is in your soul is determined by the word, the level and degree of appetite of your soul. Oh, glory to God. Oh, we going somewhere now, y'all. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Ooh, glory to God. Amen. So my responsibility as a minister is to take away people's excuse for being defeated. No one has an excuse for being defeated. Jesus provided every solution, every antidote, every answer to all your problems. Whew, glory to God. In John 16:33, this is what he said. He said, in the world, you're going to have temptation, test, and trial, but be of good cheer. Why are you going to be of good cheer when you got all these temptation, tests, and trials? Why are you to be of good cheer? Because he said, I overcame them all for you. The Amplified Version said, I deprived it of its power to harm you. Whew, glory to God. Colossians 2, verse 14 and 15. The Bible said Jesus took everything that was offensive and opposing between us and God, he took it out of the way. He nailed it to the cross. Woo! All our rebellion, sin, transgression, wickedness, amen. Jesus took it out of the way and nailed it to the cross. He put your sickness on the cross, your disease on the cross, your worry, your fear, your anxiety, amen, your depression, your poverty, lack. He put it on the cross. Woo! Glory. Amen. And then he did something to the devil, amen, in his death, burial, and resurrection. What did he do? In Colossians 2:15, he describes us what he did to our adversary. The Bible says he spoiled principalities and powers. He made an open show of them. He triumphed over them in it. Woo, glory to God. And then in Luke 10, verse 17 through 19, he told his disciples, he said, I saw Satan fall from heaven as lightning. Woo, glory. And he said, behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. That's what Jesus said. Amen. Glory to God. So we don't have no excuse for being defeated. Amen. I said, we don't have no excuse for being defeated. Now, here's the reason why people live in defeat. I'm going to show you. There are three reasons. Number one, amen, because of lack of knowledge. Hosea 4:6, God's people are destroyed for what? Lack of knowledge. Amen. And it's not that they didn't have an opportunity to get it. They just rejected it. See, they put other things before it. Amen. Woo, glory to God. Now watch this. We're going to get back on the degree and state of your soul is determined by the degree of word that you feed it. Amen. Now watch this. Now, number two, amen, glory to God, wrong relationships. Amen. Wrong relationships. Amen. Galatians 5 verse 7. You did run well, but who hindered you? Psalms 1 chapter 1 verse 1. Blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. In his law do he meditate day and night. He shall be like a leaf planted, a tree planted by the rivers of living water. His leaf won't wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Glory to God. See, wrong relationships will always hinder your progress. The man started out walking. He went from walking to standing. He went from standing to sitting as a result of what he was listening to and the people he was company with. Amen. Chapter 5, verse 20. Proverbs 5, verse 20. Proverbs 13, verse 20. He that keeps company with the wise will be wise, but a companion of fools will be destroyed. Glory to God. Now, who determines if somebody is wise, and who determines if someone is a fool? Jesus do. And this is how he determined it. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 through 26, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken unto him a wise man, which built his house upon the rock. The rain descended, the floods came, the winds blew, beat up against it, and it fell not. Why? Because it was founded based upon doing what Jesus, hearing and doing what Jesus said. Now, who does Jesus consider a fool? Whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them not, I will liken unto him a foolish man, which did what? Built his house, his marriage, his business, his ministry upon the sand. And when the rains, the floods, the winds blew, beat up against it, it fell. And great was the fall of it. Why? Because it was built upon hearing and not doing what Jesus said. Amen. Glory to God. So people can have degrees, accolades, and credentials, position, monies, and still be a fool. Amen. It's certain tests and trials and challenges in life that they can't overcome. Amen. Woo, they don't have no answer to. Amen. Glory to God. Jesus got the answer to everything. He's the solution to every problem. Glory to God. He defeated death, hell, and the grave. He rose victorious over Satan and all of his cohorts. He's seated in heavenly places right alongside with God. Amen. Glory to God. And what he say goes. Woo! He's the habitual truth teller. He's the one without error. Jesus can't produce a lie. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Now, the third thing. See, we're talking about things that defeat people. Because we don't have an excuse for being defeated. We don't have an excuse, amen, for being defeated. No. The Bible said, thanks be unto God who always causes us to triumph. Amen. 2 Corinthians 2, verse 14. Amen. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 57. Thanks be unto God who always gives us the victory. Romans 8, 37. We're more than conquerors through him that loved us. Glory to God. We don't have no excuse for being defeated. Jesus took away all of them. In Matthew 11, verse 28, he said, come unto me, all ye that laden and heavily laden, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Learn of me. Woo, glory to God. And you'll have rest for your soul. Jesus got the answer to everything. We don't have no excuse for being defeated. None at all. Glory to God. But there are three things that cause defeat in a person's life. Lack of knowledge, wrong company, wrong relationships, the things that accompany you. Amen. The company you keep determines what accompanies you. Amen. Proverbs 13, 20. A companion, amen, of wise men will become wise, but a companion of fools will be destroyed. Amen. And then number three, wrong choices. Wrong choices. That's what defeat people. Wrong choices. Amen. The Bible says Amen. In Deuteronomy 30, verse 19, he said, I set before you life, death, blessings, curses. Therefore, choose life. Choose. He tell you what to choose, but he can't choose for you. Choose life so you and your seed can live. Glory to God. Amen. So your success or defeat is a result of your knowledge component, is a result of relationships you keep, and it's a result of the choices you make. Mm. So there go all your excuses out the window. Amen. The blame game is over. Amen. Ain't no sense of blaming the white man. Ain't no sense of blaming, amen, the politics. Ain't no sense of blaming the way you grew up, what happened to you. I know all these things are detrimental, and they may have happened to you, but I'm telling you, Jesus is the answer to all that. He done something about it. Woo, glory to God. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 15, he was tempted in all points, yet without sin. Let's just read a few scriptures. Amen. Glory to God that talk about, amen, how he went through everything we went through. He went through and defeated everything that we'll ever go through. I said he went through it and defeated it. I said he went through it and defeated it. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. Woo, glory to God. He know what you're going through. He know what you're facing. He know what you're dealing with. And he also know how to bring you out. Whew, glory to God. I said he know how to bring you out. Woo, glory to God. And when Jesus bring you out, amen, he not only bring you out, amen, but he bring you out, amen, in redemptive restoration portion. Woo, glory to God. Look at the prodigal son when he came to himself. He said, I know what I do. I'll go back to my father's house. Amen. And the Bible said why he was on the way. Luke 15, starting in verse 19. The Bible says, amen, the father saw him coming and ran to him, hugged his neck, put a ring on his finger, kissed him, put the best robe on his back, ate shoes on his feet, and then he killed the fatted calf and had a celebration. Go, God always bring you back better than you left. Woo, glory to God. He make the devil pay for messing with you. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Now watch this. Quit talking like and acting like ain't nobody never been through what you going through. That's what the devil wants you to think. Nobody don't understand. Jesus understand. He tasted death for every man. Woo, glory to God. There ain't no higher death than eternal death. Jesus tasted that for us. See, when we think of death, we think of physical death. Amen. But when God think of death, he think of eternal death, eternal separation from good, from mercy, from victory. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. But Jesus tasted eternal death for us. He tasted it for us. Woo, glory to God. And that's what sickness come from. That's where disease come from. That's where poverty come from. It all, worry, fear, anxiety, all of it come from death. It's a product of death. And death means separation. Amen. When Adam sinned in the Garden of Eden, amen, glory to God, he became separated from God. Amen. That just simply means when he sinned, amen, we were affected by it, even though we didn't sin like he did, but we were affected by it. Amen. Just simply mean this. It's like this. If your parents, if they went out and robbed a bank, got put in prison, you didn't rob the bank. But as a child, you had to grow up without your parents, without their love, without their provision, without their nurturing, without their care. Amen. See, you were affected by what they did. Amen. Glory to God. So even as a parent, as we are parents, we must make choices, have relationships, and get knowledge based upon how it's going to affect our kids. We got to give others a voice in our choice if we really love them. Amen. Because whoever you love, they show up in your choice. Amen. Whoever don't have a voice in your choice, you don't love them. Amen. Glory to God. Boy, that's powerful right there. That's why we call this word encounter, because we just get right into the word. Amen. Ain't no playing around, wishing, fishing, and all this. No philosophy. No, it's Jesus. It's the Holy Ghost. It's the word. Because all you need is a word, I'm telling you. Amen. Now, Jesus, I'm pointing you to him now. I'm pointing you to him and what he said. Amen. Glory to God. Because all you need is a word. It's one thing that answers everything, and that's the word. And see, many people, they got value on temporal things and not on eternal things. Amen. Glory to God. And see, if you deal with the cause, it will change the effect. But many people are trying to change the effect and leaving the cause undealt with. Amen. Glory to God. In order to deal properly with the effect, you have to do something about the cause. What's causing this effect? Glory to God. Woo, glory to God. And every deficiency, destruction force in the earth is a product of death being separated from God. Amen. Glory. Well, I ain't separated from God. Well, just check on your thinking. What kind of thoughts you keep? Amen. Because to the degree that he's present in your thoughts, that's the degree that he's present in your choices. As a man thinketh, so is he. Proverbs 23, verse 27. Amen. If God is not present in the thoughts, you need to go get him and make him present. Woo! That's why the Bible tells us in Philippians 4, verse 8, think on things that are true, just, pure, lovely, honest, and of a good report. Amen. Why? If you keep your thinking on that, you're going to keep Jesus present. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. Oh, this is a good word, y'all. Now, let me get back over here. Amen. Amen. Because many people, amen, and I say this with all compassion and honesty and mercy, amen, but many people don't understand, amen, that their eternal existence, amen, determines their temporal one. Ooh, glory to God. See, the value you put, see, watch this. Now, let me say this. Now, you can tell where your degree of interest is, whether it's in the things of God or the, you know, other things. Just what excites you? Amen. The things of God are the things of this world. The things of eternity are the things of time. The things of prayer, amen, the things of serving God, amen. Does that excite you? Does that stir you up? Does that light you up? Does that interest you? Glory to God. See, whatever interests you, whatever occupies you, amen, that's what you're living at. That's your state right there. And many people, the things of eternity doesn't concern them. The things of time do. Amen. The things of God don't concern them. The things of self do. Glory to God. Are you seeing this today? Amen. But the Lord had to help you see that you're going to live forever. Amen. Glory to God. So you're building on eternity. And any builder, amen, he needs three things in order to build something. What do you need? You need a set of plans. Here they go right here, the word of God. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Any builder without a set of plans, he liable to build anything. And your plans had to be approved by the government. Amen. If your plans are not approved by the government, then no permit will be issued to you to build. And these plans, oh, this word has been approved by the government of God. Oh, glory to God. Now you're permitted to build. The Bible says in Psalms 127, unless the Lord builds the house, they that build it labored in vain. Glory to God. See, we're all building something, but what plans are you building off of? Amen. The things of self are the things of God. The things of time are the things of eternity. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. What plans are you following? Your own opinions are what Jesus said. Amen. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. So every builder needs three things. He needs a set of plans. Amen. And then number two, he needs contractors, our relationships. Woo! See, what are the relationships you in consistent with you building with God? Mm. Glory to God. Ask yourself. Go through your contact list in your phone. Ask yourself, is sister so-and-so, brother so-and-so, can they still help me build with God? Amen. Glory to God. The Bible tells us, amen, glory to God, in 1 Peter 2, verse 9, amen, you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, woo, called forth out of darkness into his marvelous light to show forth the praises of him. With these relationships, help me build that. Amen, glory to God. Are you seeing this? Amen, praise the Lord. See, we're all, if we're saved, born again, we're believing to spend forever with Jesus. With these relationships I'm currently in, would they be consistent with my relationship with Jesus? Woo! Glory. Would they interfere with my relationship, my fellowship with him? Would they help me build with him or against him? Mm. See, we're talking about, amen, your interests, the interests of your soul. Amen. Is it gravitating to the things of self or the things of God? The things of time are the things of eternity. Amen. You can just check this out. I'm just having us to look at this thing because we're living in a world is flooded with deception and lies. Amen. It's anti-Christ, y'all. Amen. Glory to God. And the Bible tells us in 1 Peter, all through the Gospels, you know, Jesus warned the people, amen, to pay attention, amen, to false prophecy, false prophets, amen, glory to God, to pay attention to doctrine and instruction. Amen. And he gauged it by this, a tree is known by his fruit. Mm. Glory to God. What kind of fruit? Are we reproducing Jesus? Amen. Or reproducing ourselves? I know this is a little difficult for some of you to hear, but you need to hear it. I'm serious. I had to hear it. Amen. Amen. Because I had been in wrong instruction, wrong relationship, wrong choices. And see, if you stay in that too long, what'll happen is it's like fracturing or injuring your bone or your one of your joints. Amen. You can't keep using it. You got to put it, let it set and correct it. You got to let it heal before you go back and use it. Amen. And that's what good teaching and right relationships do. They put you in a cask. Amen. Glory to God. They set you so, and they start the healing process. Amen. And that's why we should have people that we are accountable to. Amen. Glory to God. It's safety in those settings. Safety in those relationships. Amen. Glory to God. Apart from those settings and relationships, we come up with our own opinion, our own standard, our own rules. Amen. And the Bible tells us in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 through 7, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't lean on your own understanding, but in all your ways, acknowledge him, what he did, what he said, what he promised, who he is. Acknowledge him, and he'll direct your paths. Woo! See, let Jesus make decisions for you. Woo! He whooped everything, conquered everything, defeated everything. Glory be to God. Oh, this is so powerful, y'all. This, This is just a good talking to. We just having a good discussion tonight. Amen. What are our values on? What do we esteem and appreciate and value? Amen. What do we hold dear and precious to us? The things of time are the things of eternity. The things of God are the things of self. The things of this world are the things of heaven. Jesus said we in the world, but we're not of it. This is just the place we work at. It ain't our home, y'all. Matter of fact, Romans 12, verse 1 and 2, I beseech you, therefore, by the mercies of God, that you present your body to him as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto him, which is our reasonable service. Verse 2, don't be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed. How? By the renewing of your mind, watching what your soul eat, latch hold to, gravitate to. Woo! Glory to God. So that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Your soul, what it gravitates to, what it esteems and appreciates, determines your conformity or your transformity. See, you either transform or conformed by what your soul, the appetite of your soul. Is your soul appetite the things of self or the things of God? The things of time are the things of eternity. The things of earth and this world are the things of heaven. Whew. And you know, you control your appetite and what you eat. You can go in the restaurant. You know, if people watch what they eat soulishly, like what they watch what they eat naturally, woo, man, they wouldn't have no problems. That's not solvable. They'll have the solution and answer to all their crises. Amen. Whew, boy, that's a good word, y'all. Now watch this. Your soul has an appetite. Amen. And your soul appetites gravitates to the word. Look there with me, if you would, to James chapter 1. Look at verse 21. It says, receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to do what? Save your soul. Whew. See, your soul gravitates to the word. That's what it feeds off of. It's like the water. I mean, it's like the seed can't do without the ground. Nor can your soul do without the word. See, your soul is the ground. The word is the seed. And Jesus is the sower. Woo, glory to God. Just like you can't get no seed without going to landscaping place. You know what I'm talking about. You can't get no seed without going there. So you can't get no word without Jesus. Glory to God. And the word is no good without the soul. It need a ground to plant in. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. The Bible talks about this in the book of Matthew, chapter 13, in the book of Luke, chapter 8, and in Mark, chapter 4. It talks about the parable of the sower. And if you look at all three parables, amen, it talks about four types of ground, four types of conditions of the soul. You got wayside. Amen. You got, amen, stony ground. Amen. You got thorny ground and you got good ground. Whew, which ground are we? Glory to God. See, the ground, the condition of your soul is determined by one thing, how you receive the word. And how you receive the word is determined by one thing. What is that one thing? Meekness. James 1:21. Receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. And what does meekness mean? Amen. I'm receiving what Jesus say without protest, argument, or without wishing it was different. Amen. That determines the ground of your soul. Amen. Your meekness, your humility determines your dependency. Oh, glory to God. Amen. Determines the ground of your soul. And see, what the world and the enemy will try to do, your flesh, it'll try to tell you, hey, amen, you don't need to pay attention to your diet for the word of God. You don't need to pay attention to your soul. You can just deal with that some other time. Glory to God. See, the devil and the flesh and the world, they want your soul on a fast. They want you to fast the word, the things of God. Woo, glory to God. But you got to end that fast. Woo, glory to God. And you got to feed and nurture. Glory to God. And nourish. Amen. Your soul appetite with the word. Woo, you got to see your need for it. You got to see that apart from the word, you're nothing, can do nothing, you have nothing, and you are nothing. Woo, glory to God. Amen. Glory be to God. Jesus said in John 6:63, amen, the flesh profit nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Glory to God. Amen. Jesus told the disciples in Acts 5, verse 20, go stand in the temple, in the streets, and preach to the people all the words that pertain to this life. Amen. Whatever you dealing with in life, God got a word that pertains it. Woo! He got a word pertaining poverty. He got a word pertaining lack. He got a word pertaining sickness and disease. He got a word pertaining worry and fear. He got a word pertaining your family, your career, your business, your ministry. Everything that pertains to this life, Jesus got a word for it. But like I said, the word is no good without a soul to plant it in. Glory to God. And see, many Christians, they, you know, service their appetite with the things of the world. And then when it comes to church, when it comes to prayer, when it comes to the things of God, they have no appetite, no interest. And if the interest is there, it's law and dutiful, slavish. Woo! It ain't no get to. I'm glad to. Look there in Acts chapter 2, amen, verse 41. The Bible says, and they that gladly received his word. Woo, glory to God. Amen. See, where that at when it come time to read your daily chapter, when it come time to go to church, when it come time to serve the Lord, where's that gladness at? See, that determines the interests of the soul. And changing the interests of the soul is like changing your physical diet. It's painful. Woo! That's why Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, if your eye offend you, pluck it out. If your hand offend you, cut it off. See, that's what it feels like. Oh, glory to God. But you got to see it as an offense to you. Amen. Glory to God. You don't want something keep offending you without cutting it off, even in your body. You know, if an organ or something get in there, amen, that's offensive to the other parts and organs and tissues of your body. If you don't receive your healing and you go to the doctor, what he going to say? Man, we got to cut that out. That's offensive to the other parts of your body. Woo! Glory to God. So if you keep feeding your natural man things that's offensive to it, you're going to keep experiencing destruction. So it is when you feed your soulish man something other than the word of God, it's going to destroy it. Amen. Boy, this word encounter tonight, y'all. Because your soul determines what comes into your life. Your soul determines the degree of health and wealth and prosperity that you walk in. Amen. Look there in 3 John chapter 1. Look at verse 2. He said, beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper. Oh, glory to God. So the prosperity of your soul determines the degree of health and wealth, the degree of life you experience and obtain. Amen. Glory to God. So it's vital and of necessity that you change and develop the appetite, that you school the appetite of your soul. And your soul is made up of your appetites, your affections, your emotions, your will. Amen. Your priorities and interests, all that make up your soul. Amen. Glory to God. And you have to school that, develop that, train that. Just like you do your children. People think you raise your children. No, you raise animals, chickens and rabbits and horses and dogs. You raise them. Amen. But you train children. Proverbs 22, verse 6, train up a child in the way they should go. And when they are old, they won't depart. And see, in order to train, amen, glory to God, you need, amen, the word. Amen, you need policies and procedures. You need a set of plans. Glory to God. Amen. You need right relationships. And you need to make right choices. Glory to God. Amen. See, don't let the world, the devil, amen, and what you're facing and going through school the appetite of your soul. No, you take control. You manage it. Glory to God. All of us got 24 hours in a day. Everybody got the same. Amen. And you either spending your time, are you investing it? Glory to God. Just like money, everybody get money. They either spend it or invest it. Amen. I got three principles with money. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. I give some, I spend some, and I save some. Woo, glory to God. I give, spend, save. Woo, glory to God. Amen. You don't spend what you should be giving, and you don't spend what you should be saving. Glory to God. Boy, that Pastor Mike, boy, he's something. No, he ain't. Jesus is. See how the soul, see, you have to be mad. You have to be correcting it, man. If you don't ever correct yourself, you ain't even trying. Amen. You just in a tunnel. Amen. You in a yoke, following whatever. No, you got to pay attention. Amen. Just like I did at Pastor Mike. He's something. Boy, I caught that. I caught that. I caught that. Why? Because I ain't nothing. I don't have nothing. Can't do nothing. I don't know nothing without Jesus. He's something. Woo! See, that's meekness. That's humility right there. Receive with meekness. The engrafted word, which is able to do what? Save your soul. See, if my soul wasn't being saved, I wouldn't have caught myself. I would have just let that statement ride. And guess what? It would have picked up momentum. Amen. Glory to God. And it would have took me right out of him and into me. And that's what the devil wants. He wants you in you, your own opinion, what you think. And if he can get you over there, he done got you away from Jesus. Glory to God. See, Jesus had to, first let me go over here and show you. Well, let me show you this right here. Jesus, he was paying attention, man. He did. Even to relationships, you can't let your relationship have so much influence over you that when they say something opposing to Jesus, offensive to him, that you don't stand with Jesus. Amen. Watch this. Look there. Here's a perfect example. Look there with me in Matthew chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16. Y'all working with me? Amen. Glory to God. I guess we can call this message for those of you who are helping us in the media department. We appreciate you so much. You are so valuable, amen, to the ministry, the kingdom. Amen. We We celebrate your commitment and love for the Lord and his people. Amen. But if we were to put a title on this message, we could call it Schooling and Developing the Interests of Our Soul. Or, amen, Managing Our Soul's Interests. Boy, that's good right there. How to manage our soul's interests. Something of that nature. Y'all listen to the Holy Ghost and put that. Amen. I have to trust y'all in that department. Amen. Glory to God. Because the interests of your soul is a result of your management. Glory to God. And your soul has an appetite, and its appetite is the word. Man should not live by bread alone. Jesus talked about your soul living, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul, James 1:21. And then in 3 John chapter 1, verse 2, beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper. Amen. And your soul cannot prosper without the word. Amen. Glory to God. So you have to manage, school, and develop your soul's interest in the word, or else it'll try to gravitate to other things. It'll partner with your flesh, partner with the world, partner with the devil, and it'll be lost. See, it'll be gravitating to death, separation from God. That's what death is. Amen. Now, here we go. Look here with me, if you would, to Matthew 16. Now, Jesus, in verse 13, he asked Peter and his disciples a question. Who the man say that I am? They answer, respond. Some say you're Jeremiah, Elijah, one of the prophets. Jesus answered back, who do you say that I am? Peter answered, you're the Christ, the Son of the Most High God. Jesus responded, flesh and blood ain't revealed this to you, Peter, but my Father, which is in heaven. And up on this rock, I'm going to build my church in the gates of hell. Would not prevail. See, there go all your problems answered right there. Upon this rock, this revelation of who I am, what I said, what I did, what I promised. The gates of hell can't prevail against it. Woo, glory to God. Woo, hallelujah. Glory to God. Now, here it is. They still in the same setting. And Jesus started telling them about him going to the cross, paying the penalty for mankind's sin, how people were going to persecute him and kill him, mock him. Amen. And so verse 22, then Peter, the same one now, who answered correctly previously, who Jesus commended. Amen. Glory to God. The same Peter. See, you can go in and out, just like relationships. They can go in and out where the things of God and the things of self is concerned. You got to watch your management. Watch this. Same Peter who answered rightly previously. Watch how he answered this time. Then Peter said, took him and began to do what? Rebuke him. Don't you know Peter, people can do that to Jesus? Even now they can rebuke him. When he said, I'm your shepherd and you shall not want. I took your infirmities and bore your sicknesses. When you died on the tree by my stripes, you're healed. I supply all your needs according to my riches and glory by Christ Jesus. You're more than a conqueror through him that loved you. See, oh no, you don't know what I'm facing and going through. See, you rebuking him. Love your enemy, pray for them, bless those who despitefully use you and persecute you. If your enemy hunger, feed him. If he thirsty, give him something to drink. I ain't giving him nothing. I'm going to feed him with a long, I'm going to love him from a distance. See, you rebuking Jesus. Now watch this. Boy, this good teaching. A lot of people don't like sound doctrine like this, y'all, I'm telling you. Man, I be talking to people out in the street, Starbucks, different places I go, you know, here and there. And they retention for the truth is minimum. They can only handle, I keep telling them truth is like medicine. I don't take it for the taste. I take it for the effects. See, any truth, any doctrine that don't reproduce Jesus, it ain't of him. It's just your own opinion. Whew. Glory to God. Praise God. Now watch this. Here we go. Notice here. Then Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, that be far from thee, Lord. Amen. This shall not be unto thee. So Jesus telling, Peter telling Jesus, it ain't going to happen like that. Watch how Jesus dealt with him. Notice where Peter's, what's causing this effect. See, we're dealing with the cause and then the effect will be dealt with. But many people are trying to deal with the effect without dealing with the cause. And Jesus finna tell Peter what's causing this. Watch what he said, verse 23. Then he turned and said unto Peter, get thee behind me, Satan. Watch this. Why is he connecting Peter with Satan? Because thou, listen to this, because thou art an offense unto me. What made Peter an offense to Jesus? Because he savor, he value, he appreciate and esteem the things of man over the things of God. Glory to God. Can y'all see that right there? Amen. And you have to be woke. You have to be alert, tentative, watchful. You can't be asleep. Not when you're dealing with Jesus and your soul. Amen. This is your soul you're doing business with. Jesus said in Matthew 16, let's go, let's read a little farther. Matthew 16, he's going to break it down to him. Notice what he said. Amen. Then Jesus said unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, he got to do what? Deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. You can't follow someone without doing what they say. Many people come to Jesus, but they don't follow him by doing what he say. Notice here, amen. Look at verse, Jesus said in John 15:14, you are my friend if you do what I say. In Luke 8, verse 18 and 19, Jesus' mother, sister, brother, they came to him. He was in a meeting preaching. And they came and told him, hey, Jesus, your mother, sister, brother, your family out there, they want to see you. And Jesus turned to his disciples and said, my mother, my sister, my brother, my family are those who hear the word and do it. Everybody ain't your family. They may be natural, genealogical, but they really your family spiritually, soulishly, if they hear and do what Jesus say. Man, boy, this is good. See, because he's trying to get you ready to spend forever with him. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. He's trying to fit our soul for heaven. Woo! Glory. Ain't nobody going to be up there that oppose what he say. Ain't nobody going to be with him eternity disagreeing with him. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. So he's trying to get us ready for that. Whew, glory to God. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Now watch this. He said, whosoever followed me, he got to deny me, take up his cross daily and follow me. Look at verse 26. For what is a man profit if he shall gain the whole world and yet lose his soul? Can y'all see that? See, he was mindful, valuing the things of time versus the thing of eternity. The things of self more than the things of God. The things of earth more than the things of heaven. So he lost his soul trying to get that. Notice what else Jesus said. Amen. Woo, glory. Woo, hallelujah. I felt the anointing right there, y'all. I felt a shift in your soul, a shift in our choosing and refusing. I saw somebody, some light broke through. Whew, glory. It dislodged you from death, connected you to Jesus. And now what's in him is flowing in you. Life, his nature, his power, his virtue, his anointing is flowing in you right now. Woo, glory. Quickening every deformity, every disease, every sickness, every weakness in your body. Receive this life that Jesus came to give. Receive it in its fullest measure. Receive it in you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Woo, glory to God. I had to stop and do that because people, amen to Lord. Woo, glory to God. Amen. There's a shifting and a lifting right now in your soul. It's lifted you out of that dung hill, out of that miry clay, and it's put your feet on a rock of the word of God and what Jesus say. Whew. Now, not only receive your healing and deliverance and your prosperity, but keep it by managing the interests of your soul. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. Now, let me show you how to do that. Go over here. Amen. Glory to God, to Psalms 103. Matter of fact, I want you to read this chapter out loud at least 3 times a day for the next 7 days. For the next 7 days, this whole chapter, read it out loud. Amen. Don't try to read. You know, a lot of people eat their food standing up and they don't enjoy it. But the food you eat sitting down, whew, man, you just enjoy that. So eat this, not standing up. You know, other things got your interest and so forth. But eat this sitting down 3 times a day for the next 7 days. Oh, well, yeah. See, that go your soul interest. See where the interests of your soul gravitating to? See, it's looking at it, the burden of it instead of the investment. Woo, glory be to God. See, I told you my assignment this year from the Lord is to get rid of people's excuses for being defeated. That's my assignment, is to get rid of people's excuses for living defeated. Glory be to God. Woo, glory. Now, look here with me. David had to do this. That's why he never lost a battle. Amen. David never lost one battle. All of his tests turned into testimony. All of his trials turned into triumphs. Boy, Jesus changed his story and made him a story to be told, made him a specter, made him a wonder to his world. Glory to God. And this was the key right here, right? What I'm finna get ready to read. Your assignment this week, this is the key. He managed the interests of his soul, because his soul was the gateway, was the determining factor of what entered into his life, what stayed in his life. Nothing can enter and stay in your life without the cooperation and the consent of your soul. Remember your soul, amen, is your appetites, your passions, your affections, your emotions, your will, and your choice, and your priorities and interests. That's what makes up the compartment of your soul. Amen. And that's what has to be managed. And you can only manage it with doing what Jesus say. He's the savior of the soul. So we got to let him tell us how to save it. Amen, or else it'll be lost. Now watch this. David said, bless the Lord. Who are you talking to? Oh, my soul, my interests, priorities, preferences, affections, emotions, passions, appetites, choosing and refusing. You bless the Lord. You stay connected to him. What he say, who he is, what he did, what he promised. Don't be dating him. Don't put the ring on. Marry him. Whew, glory to God. Your soul can't have no other lovers. It can't serve two masters. Glory to God. You got to despise one and love the other. Glory to God. Amen. I remember one time I got through praying. You know, I was hoping that hour would go by, you know, and when I got through, I said, phew. And the Lord said, what are you going to do now? And I said, wait, what do you mean? He said, well, you through praying. What are you going to do now? And then this idea came into my mind. Well, if God always hear me and see me, then I'm still praying. Even though I ain't kneeled down, I'm still praying because he hear and see me. So what I do and say got to match what I prayed on my knees, unless my prayers are not sincere. And so the Lord gave me this statement. Amen. Sincere prayer is when we watch what we say after we pray. Boy, that gangster right there. I said, sincere prayer is when we watch what we say after we pray. See, what we say after we pray is just as important as what we were saying while we were praying. Two can't walk together unless they agree. All right, now, here we go. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. What are some of these benefits? Who healeth, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thine diseases, who redeems thy life from destruction. Woo, glory to God. Who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies. Woo, who satisfies thee. Woo, glory to God. With what? Good things, so that your youth is renewed as the eagles. Can y'all see this? Now you ought to read that three times a day. Glory to God. And watch how your soul, watch how it get revived. Watch how it spring up. Watch how it gravitate to Jesus. Watch how it start reminding you of things that God said, spoken, and done for you. Whew. Watch how you be properly aligned with him. And watch in the next 2 months, in the rest of June and all of July. Whew, glory to God. Woo! There's going to be a lifting and a shifting. Glory to God. That's the Lord is going to minister to you grace for another supernatural start and new beginnings. In Jesus' name, amen. Glory to God. Well, I love you so much. Amen. Glory to God. This time just flew by. Amen. Glory to God. I can see why the Lord would have us to just get straight into the word, the whole word encounter hour. Amen. I trust that you took good notes. Amen. That the Spirit of God ministered to you, that he took this word, wrote it up on the tablets of your heart. Amen. And in days to come, amen, you'll meditate on it. Amen. Glory to God. Not just be a hearer, but a doer of the word. And Jesus will be reproduced in your life. Amen. Glory to God. Well, so many things coming up this week at the church. I don't have time to just tell you about all of them. Why don't you just do your future, amen, a favor? Amen. Go to the Facebook page and just look at, amen, the services that are coming up, the things that we're doing there at the ministry. Amen. Pray with us. Pray for us. Amen. Glory to God. Be a part, amen, of these endeavors. Amen. Glory to God. I'm telling you, amen. The Lord is on him. He's on the move. Amen. I'm telling you, he is on the move, you all. Amen. So many testimonies, praise reports. Amen. Coming from the ministry, the people of the ministry. Amen. The Lord is ministering to us grace. Amen. For another supernatural start, new beginnings. Amen. Corporate prayer begins tomorrow, 6 a.m. Boy, that prayer line been rocking this week. Today was corporate prayer and fasting day. Amen. Glory to God. I'm telling you, those fasting mantles, those prophetic mantles that's been spoken over us, amen, they are, amen, manifesting in the lives of the people who are in the system, who are engaged. Amen. Don't be a spectator, be a participator and a partaker. Amen. Well, I don't have time to really go to the offering message today, but you know, amen, that every lover gives. It's impossible to love without giving. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So giving is a demonstration, an expression of our love. Amen. Go to the website. You can see the information right there. We're involved in so many things. Amen. Outreaches in the ministry. Amen. And so forth. Well, we love you so much. It is our prayer to our Heavenly Father on your behalf that God's richest and best be yours.